Children, now moving on to the key features of our constitution. Children, our constitution has a parliamentary form of government. Now, what is this parliamentary form of government? This parliamentary form of government actually tells that the constitution provides for the parliamentary form at the center and in the states. Like, if you all remember, the president and the state governors are the nominal heads of the executives. The real power is vested in the hands of the Council of Ministers, which is headed by the Prime Minister at the center, and the chief ministers in the states. They belong to the majority party in the parliament and the state legislature. I hope this first feature, parliamentary form of government, is clear to all of you. Children, we also have a bicameral legislature. Now, this bicameral legislature, actually, you know, it tells us that our constitution provides for two houses of parliament. At the center, the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, where the Lok Sabha is the lower house with approximately 545 members or 550 members who are directly elected for 5 years by the voters of the age of 18 years or more. And the Rajya Sabha is the upper house representing the state of the Indian Union. It is a permanent house with 3 members retiring after every 2 years. Children, about this bicameral legislature, we'll be reading in our chapters which are there. So, in the coming chapters, we'll be reading it in proper details that what is this Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha and the bicameral legislature. Now, moving on to the second key feature of the constitution is federalism.